As for any structured dataset, we have the unique identifier, or the ID, which in this case represents an individual application for a loan. Each row is what I like to call the unity of measure, which concerns a specific transaction, or in this case, a specific loan application. We have more information about each application, such as the applicant's ID, name, age, occupation, annual income, monthly salary, bank account information, loan details, or transaction history. The credit underscore score feature indicates whether or not each application has a good or a bad credit score. This credit score feature is our goal or our target. It is the column whose values we are going to predict so that for new applications, we have an accurate approximation of what a good or a bad loan application looks like. To rephrase, based on the historical data that was provided by the dataset, Driverless AI is going to train accurate models to help us detect whether new applications are going to have a good or a bad credit score. This is our business case, and the better we are at predicting bad credit score applications, the faster we are going to avoid giving a loan to people who are most likely to default and not reimburse their loan anymore. In this process, we are not going to run just one model at a time, as we would normally do manually in our own Python notebook. With Driverless AI, it's like you have a hive mind of Kaggle grandmasters offering support at all times and coming to your aid to make sure that the most accurate and the most suited machine learning models are being run in parallel and that the best ones are pushed forward. Now, let's focus on the status column from the dataset tab and click on the button Click for Actions or in any other place of the creditscore.csv row. There is a drop-down window that appears with the following options. Details, where you can preview the dataset, you get the descriptive summary, and you can also modify the data directly in the platform by adding a recipe. The Visualize button is the place where you get automatic visualizations for the dataset. There is a data prep option for the Driverless AI version that we are working with right now, and here you can transform or split your dataset. In previous versions, there was only a split button instead. Next up, we have the Predict button, the place where we are going to spend the most part of our time, as this is where we will set up our first experiment with Driverless AI, launch it, and see the results. And on this drop-down menu, you also have the options to rename the dataset, download it, display logs, and delete the dataset. These options that I just presented are the same for each dataset. So next, let's focus a bit more on them.